Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm doing my updated everyday makeup routine. It's very simple and glowy and natural. So I'm just gonna show you guys everything that I use, all the products and everything, and how I get this makeup right here that I do whenever I wanna put on makeup. And I hope you guys like the video, so roll the clip. Okay, so I already washed my face and I put moisturizer on. I do that every time before I do makeup. And then I'm also just going to, since I recently got curtain bangs, if you didn't know, now you can see, I'm going to clip these back with these little pearl clips that I have. And they look a little funny at first, but they do the job. And I also have some dry skin out here because I have some friends that are joining us today. I usually have pretty good, like, clear skin, but my skin has not been liking me these past few days, so we're gonna have to cover up those. Also, I gotta show you my cute makeup bag. Look how cute. It has like little hearts because it was like for Valentine's Day. But anyway, and if I look over here, it's because I have a mirror right here. Okay, so the first thing that I do is I take the e.l.f. Camo Concealer and I have it in the shade Medium Sand, and I usually don't do this because I usually don't have any breakouts or pimples, but today we do. So I just put it on wherever I want to cover up, and I kind of work in sections, so I'm gonna do these first. But to blend that in, I use one of these little brushes. This is literally from like Amazon. Blended, since these are like really bad, and if they look super dry, I'm so sorry, they're like scabbed. But I'm gonna take this Lancome foundation powder. This is literally from my mom, and I'm just gonna take this Real Techniques brush and just go over that. Then for my like translucent powder to just set where I'm like oily, like in my T-zone, I use this little Ciate London translucent powder, and it's like a baby. I take this little brush that I got in the Ipsy one time, and it's so pretty and cute, and I literally just take some of this and I go on the corners of my nose. Do you ever wake up feeling like within the strange reason that I won't wait? And then I also take it up on my like forehead, just right here in the center, and blend that all in. And then I also take it under my eyes and on my eyelids, because my eyelids crease right there even when I don't put concealer. Okay, so then after I'm done with all my powder and everything, I go in with the blush, and this is my favorite part. This is a new product for me. I got this a few weeks ago when I went to Sephora, when I spent $250 at Sephora, we'll put it that way. But it's the Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk blush, and it is so pretty. Look at that. Definitely worth it. Take it on this little Luxie like blush stippling brush, and I apply this like almost on top of my like cheekbone to give a more lifted look, and then I bring it down right here a little and go up to the temple. Look how much of a difference that just made. Then I'll also take some on my nose. It's true. And that's what I do. And then I also get this big crease brush that I also got in an Ipsy. And I take the blush and put it right on my brow bone. So that is all for my blush. Okay, so now that we have like all of our face stuff mainly on, I'm gonna do my eyebrows, and all I do for my eyebrows is literally just brush them. I was just staring at the ceiling, now she's starting to stare back, but I guess looks can be deceiving. And then after I'm done with that, I literally already am like done. I'm gonna do my eyelashes now. So the lashes are very important. So I take my time on this step and I have a whole little routine for my eyelashes. So if you wanna get very curled, very lengthened lashes, then watch my routine that I do because it works really good, trust me. Okay, so I use a Tarte eyelash curler and I just go in and curl them a bunch. Like I just keep curling them. Spaces we call love won't have to fade away, but till you ever wake up feeling like you're living day to day, we should buy some gold handcuffs and throw away the cane and mark yourself that into. Okay, so that is my eyelashes curled now. And then I go in with my same spoolie that I brushed out my eyebrows with, and I brush through all my lashes. Cages in the prison of belief, girl. Okay, so now that you've brushed through all your lashes and curled them, I go in with my mascara, and I use the Maybelline Sky High Mascara. And this mascara is really good. I got this for my birthday because I've been wanting to try it forever. So my mom ordered it for the both of us. So for applying mascara, I just go at the ends first and I just barely put any mascara because you don't want to weight your eyelashes down. So I just kind of blink and just do it at the tips. Baby, it's true. So that's one eye, that's the difference. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. And then I'm gonna do the same to the other eye. Okay, so that is with all the mascara on, that's what my eyelashes look like. And I'm gonna go ahead and get all the excess mascara on my eyelid and I'm gonna go in with the same spoolie. And I just kind of brush it barely against where there's mascara, and it comes off so easily. Okay, so that is my finished eyelashes, and now I'm going to go in with my favorite step. If you know me, you know that I will never be caught dead without a good nose highlight moment, but it is a Dior highlighter. Like, it comes with a sleeve, and it is stunning, and mine is in the shade Nude Luminizer. And then I go in with another Luxie brush, and first I'm going to go in on my brow bone. And this is like a very like natural like glowy highlighter. Like, it's not blinding, but then like it also is. And I put this all on my brow bone. And then I take a little bit and put it on the inner corners of my eyes. And then my favorite part, what matters the most to me, is I put it at the tip of my nose. And then I put it on the bridge of my nose slightly. I don't do as much on the bridge, and it looks like that. I can see it like catching the light, and I put a ton on the tip of my nose. And then after I put that on, I take this Luxie brush and I blend it out a little bit on my nose just so there's not like any like harsh lines from where I put it. Okay, so now for the last part, I do my lips, and I don't do that much. But I start off with this lip gloss, and if you're wondering, I put Carmex on before I do any of this. I used to just have the lip injection, like just the lip injection gloss, but now I have the Lip Injection Extreme, and I have it in clear finally. And I just apply a ton of this on my lips. But I let that like sit there and like tingle and do its magic. And then I go in with the Dior lip oil. And I think mine is in the, yeah, it's in the raspberry color or shade or whatever. And I just take this, and go over that a little bit. And that is all I do for my makeup. This is literally all I do. This is the end result. And I just like to do my makeup this way. But yeah, anyways, this is the finished makeup look. It's just very glowy, very natural. and it's just what I like.